afternoon to all the participants. Good afternoon, ma'am. I, Dr. Jaimini Vyas, welcome you on behalf of KCG. To all the participants, our today's speaker is Dr. Valentina V. Umrania. She is an associate professor and head at Microbiology Department, MVM Science and SSC College, Rajkot. Her topic is how life sciences being useful to become Atmanirbhar. I heartily welcome you on behalf of KCG, ma'am. Thank you for your presence. Hand it over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Jaimini Vyas. Welcome everybody here in this Knowledge Consortium of Gujarat. We all are sailing in the same boat, being faculty in some or the other biological science branch, and we are trying to find out the way how we faculties can be useful in every day-to-day life, in the life of self, in the life of family, in the life of students. Being a faculty, we all realize what is the important role we are playing in the society. And everywhere in the news and everywhere we are understanding and we are listening that the role of a teacher, when the teacher is making or when the teacher is structuring, cultivating a particular characteristic into a student community, then the youth of India, that is the most responsible citizens of India, are in our hands, more or less. Sometimes they are obedient, sometimes they are very much differently behaving, and sometimes they are very much highly talented. Now today, when I had a talk with KCG team, we were just talking that how this life sciences can be useful to become Atmanirbhar. Dear friends, when I talked about Atma and Nirbhar world, then few things came to my mind that till now, after attending so many conferences or after attending so many FDPN workshops, what our elders, what our seniors, what our forefathers have taught us, and that was very origin of the word knowledge. That was very origin that the knowledge is the power and the knowledge is everything. That is why we say that knowledgeable person is in front of us. We give respect to a knowledgeable person. And then we realized that we spread this knowledge among the community, which is youth. Most youthful students are in front of us. So how, as a faculty, we have to develop ourselves so that our students will become more and more responsible, more and more patriotic, and more faithful to the country. So looking to the Atmanirbhar world, I had these many things in my mind that how to correlate life, then sciences, then Atma, and then Nirbhar. So then we have started thinking about how this Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan is going on in our country. What do we mean by exactly the word Atma and Nirbhar? We can say in a very literary meaning, Atma is self and Nirbhar is dependent. So the one who is dependent on self, own self, right? The person who is dependent on self, that is Atmanirbhar. And we are talking about that person. That person is nothing but our beloved country. Bharat Mata. Bharat Mata as a person, as a energy, as a Shakti, when we think, then we can think that what is the meaning of becoming self-reliant and becoming self-sufficient. As our respected Prime Minister Modi ji has said, that a bigger and more important part of the global economy is to pursue policies. Now, which policies? That are very efficient, that are very competitive, and that are taking us towards self-sustainability. There are so many packages are also given by the country, as all of us are knowing, that what is the packages given to the, our country to become independent. Now, that was the word, Atma Nirbhar. That means not dependent on anybody else. And we have to become independent against the tough competition in the global supply, because we as a country, we have to look around us on this globe. At international platform, we have tough competition because there is a global supply chain. But when we want to become independent, then we have to help ourselves. We have to help our people. And that is how we can think about the Atmanirbhar. But in case of biological sciences, we can think that how different biological branches are connected and how they can make it easy for us to become self-reliant. It may be energy sector, which is now converted into more renewable energy sources with the help of biological agencies. How Mother Earth and nature can be made more clean. Again, clean and green. Again, we are dependent on the biological sciences, where we are having certain microorganisms, where we are having certain plants, where we are having certain bioprocesses, which will make this nature earth cleaner. In the sector transportation, how biological science will help us? It will help us like biofuel production with the help of different types of living bodies. In case of water sector, in case of waste reduction, in case of urban design, all these things which are highly important for us to become Atmanirbhar, more are there, they are dependent on the sciences, basic sciences, which are biological sciences. What is this Atmanirbhar? And how many packages are given by the government? We were looking to the different sectors, right? Different sectors which are connected with the growth of our nation, with the self-reliance of our nation. And these are the sectors in which somewhere or the other, biological sciences are also playing very important role. Because now energy can be bioenergy. In the transportation, the fuel can be biofuel. To clean the nature, there are so many bacteria and so many processes like bioremediation and biodegradation and preparation of compost and fertilizers from the waste. So that is the clean and green India, where also biological science is playing a very important role. So these things, when just I was thinking about how biological science playing a very drastic role in case of becoming self-sufficient and self-reliance. So we can say that all technological processes which are dependent on the different life forms, it may be plants, animals, or microbial life forms, but when they are connected with different types of the infrastructural development ability, different types of the factories, industries, and production of various molecules which are highly, highly important for our life. So which are the stages? How do we march towards self-sufficient India? So there are so many different stages, where micro or small or medium type of enterprises can be possible, and there we can put different types of the workers, skilled persons, highly experienced farmers. All these will play a key role because our country is Krushi Pradhan country. We are agriculture sector is very, very important, and how to improve the yield, how to improve the crop, how to improve the quality. All these things are depending upon our agriculture sector. We can have new horizons in the growth, development, and different types of the empowerment schemes in which so many skilled persons are required. The moment we think about skilled persons or skilled manpower, we can say that here is our role. Here is our role to become more self-sufficient by producing more skilled persons. So this skill development program, which is government has more emphasized, is so much important to become self-reliant. As per government sectors, there are again five pillars for the self-reliance. It may be economy, infrastructure, system, vibrant demography, and demand and supply. So these are the pillars defined and derived from our nation. But it's not very easy to happen because it's a long-term plan. And it requires certain type of the characteristic from the public also. From the public means we are having citizenship, which is taking us towards more faithfulness, towards more productive culture temperament. So here we have to have strict implementation of whatever planning we are doing, need to achieve those targets in a very, very precise manner. So all these are the elements of the society which have been included in the five pointers through which we can attain self-reliance in India. So we can say that there are so many sectors to become self-reliant, like industrial sectors, agriculture sectors, and in agriculture, which is given a secondary place till, but it's not seen as a business. If we can increase here our emphasis, then we can really, really achieve very high. By introducing new concepts of development, by introducing undertaking initiatives on skills, on the development of infrastructure, advanced infrastructure, and the schemes to increase farmers' income, all these will help us to become more and more self-reliant. But for this, one thing is very important, and that is the country needs to strengthen itself to contribute more to the world economy. Now here, what do we mean by country? What do we mean by society? Country is we, society is we, and we is made up of many, many I. And many, many I are nobody than us. So if we can unify one person with one society, we can unify one person with the whole country, and we can see the country as one person, then we can say that how to start the programming in our mind, in our heart and soul, so that we can get strengthened. How to become strengthened, how to become stronger, one of the aspects to become stronger is removal of weaknesses. If we find out how many limitations are there, how many hurdles are there in front of our country to become Atmanirbhar, then once we know which are the points, then we try to remove each one with a very much perseverance towards the goal, continuous action towards the goal. Just like what Swami Vivekananda said, Uttishtha Jagrata Prapya Varan Nibodhata. Achieve your goal, try to find out, locate your weaknesses, and then remove these weaknesses. So the success and the goal is near. In biological sciences, coming to our subject also, and coming to our role as a faculty in the society, how to achieve such kind of the strength and power. So we can say that young people should come forward for their work, and this work which is related to knowledge and technology and new research, and to make India self-reliant. Now in this new research, how many sectors we can again take up in our mind? In our mind, we can say that people or the youth or citizens have to change their attitude. They should be able to be ready. Readiness to transform from weakness towards strength, generating actions for the environment, and wherever we are having lack of skills or lack of coordination, then we can find out how to remove this lack of skills, how to generate more skills, how to have maximum efficient coordination, how to have maximum efficient teamwork. All these things, if we can achieve, then these challenges can be ruled out. So in biological sciences, where all life forms are there, if we can study in a systemic manner and take it to the application, then these applications from bench scale, from the lab scale, it can go into scaling up and it can enter into entrepreneurship. So here we can say that becoming Atmanirbhar, that is, sufficient infrastructure should be there in our country. We should have all advanced technology in our country. There must be so many industries which are based on biosciences, which are having lucrative business. And to run all these things, we should have our own skilled manpower. So in biological sciences, we can say that biohealth, agri-biotech, bioenergy sector, and bio-industrial sector, all these are the sectors which are our focus. With the help of these branches of biological science, we can achieve certain research and development strategies, we can have certain goals or targets, and we can provide best service and everything in a best manner to our country. The first best thing is to become self-sufficient. Suppose in case of agriculture sector, we are talking about enrichment of the agriculture. Now it is very much necessary to set up agro-based processing industries along with the new technologies. And once the status of an industry and farmer become prosperous, then it will not take long for India to become self-sufficient. So how many sectors we can work and how many sectors we can point out, that advancement in the technology in farming, where instead of relying only on the climatic conditions, waiting for the rain, waiting for the proper sunlight, waiting for the soil to change its structure after a year or so. Instead of that, the yield of the crop can be increased with the help of so many new technologies. Before few days only, that is on the December 15th only, this news came up, right? That in Rajkot, near Rajkot, that is in Gujarat state, Saurashtra region, near Rajkot is the Gondal, where two brothers have started farming strawberry. Now, actually, strawberry used to be only in cold climate. We cannot even imagine that in our region, where the usually temperature is almost always 28-30, and in summer it goes up to 44-45, sometimes 46. So our region is not at all actually suitable for this. But these people have started generating strawberries, and how many new ideas, how many new technologies they have started. They have totally rolls and rolls of the particular kind of the plastic. They have made that soil moisture will not come to the crop and not spoil the crop. And then they have started growing strawberry. Is this one of the best example to become Atmanirbhar? In case of biofertilizer, the first commercial biofertilizer was developed as rhizobium culture in 1890. At that time, it was known as Nitrogen. And in India, it started as an inoculant of rhizobium in 1920. And after that, systemic production began after 1950. So still we have to climb and climb that how this biofertilizer market can be studied, how it can be improved. So this biofertilizer market, when it is having different types of the particular study characteristics, that is, mode of application may be different, in which form it is used, either it is liquid or in a carrier, in which type they are used, are they nitrogen fixing bacteria, are they phosphate solubilizing, are they potash solubilizing, such kind of microorganisms are done research, and maximum potentiality into these microorganisms is possible with the help of genetic engineering. So here all of us are knowing all these facts, that by crop type this they are biofertilizers, maybe in the cereals, maybe in the fruits, vegetables and all other crop, and in which region, which part of the world, which particular biofertilizers are used, how potential they are. In India, which are the states which are producing maximum biofertilizers? What are their climatic conditions? And what are the conditions in other states? And what may be the possibility with biological sciences, with bioengineering, with genetic engineering, with improvement in the strains of biofertilizer producing microorganisms, strain improvement, all such things are possible with the help of biological science research and development. We can say that all this bioengineering will help us to produce biofuel, bioproducts, and so many other energy generating processes are going on with the help of biological engineering aspects. We can have so many data like what is world bioenergy potential in the coming years, which sector is producing maximum bioenergy, what is their plan of action, how they are working in this area, what is the biofuel production in India, how this sugarcane are growing and they are giving maximum ethanol production like in Maharashtra and Uttar Pradesh, we can see. So these are the things which we can say will make us more and more Atmanirbhar. In biogas energy, we can also say, as described, that whatever is the waste, this waste is not the waste. It should be transformed. And once if it is successfully transformed, then we are having so much of revenue generation from this waste. So waste will become wealth. It will be solving us two problems. What to do with the waste? That is one problem. Whatever processes are taken at landfill, these processes are very costly. So all this will be ruled out and there will be generation of revenue from such things after transformation. So many turnkey projects are given to us from Bhabha Atomic Research Center and so many other scientific research institution of our country. So we can say that these bio-based plastics are also made with the help of lignocellulosic feedstocks, where here we can say that bioenergy will be produced, and we can say that plastics which are made with the help of biological material, this plastic will not cause the pollution, it will not cause the particular type of the persistence in the environment, but it can be biologically degraded. I'm happy to share one of my students who is working at Junagadh Agriculture University. She has successfully produced biologically based plastic with the help of agro waste. And in a very nice manner, she is now running her research work that within how many days this plastic can be degraded. So the pollution of the plastic will be ruled out if somebody will take this as an entrepreneur. She is thinking, planning, and our government providing us SSIP kind of the projects and promoting such research which is going to make us more Atmanirbhar. So we can say that next sector is pharmaceutical sector. There also we are having that the India is the largest generic medicine, which is globally, at the global level, we are producing maximum amount of generic medicines. We know we have a belt of pharmaceutical industries near Baroda, Ankleshwar, and they are doing so good that a day is very near when we can say that we are having very good pharmaceutical sectors. The thing is how to become Atmanirbhar. The thing is which are the raw material which we are still importing from other country. So if we can emphasize on the facts and figures that how this raw material struggle can be sold out, then we can say that our pharmaceutical sector will be highly successful. So once we say that in the pharmacy, vaccine development is there. Nowadays we are knowing that this pandemic vaccine, there is a run going in the global level market that which country will become more successful in a sooner manner to produce this vaccine. But then we can say that after producing vaccine, which is the cost effective manner, how to make the vaccine which is possible for each and every layman also, poor person also, at the corner of the society, whoever is there, that every layer of the society should be considered in the mind when this vaccine production will be done in our own country, that is towards Atmanirbhar. So many startup biological science projects are going on. So many young, dynamic, energetic students are starting their own business on the basis of their fundamental knowledge, then their applied knowledge, and after application, they have started their own entrepreneurship. So we can say that sustainable development of our country and sustainable development of the whole globe. What is the role of people? What is the role of other sectors? What is happening on the planet Earth? And how we can have profit? How much profit we are having? Then we can say that this is our Atmanirbhar. So the role of people and the role of environmental sustainability is playing very important role. The role of each and every person of the country for development, for the team work culture. These things will take us towards more Atmanirbhar. So in the sustainable development, we can say that there are social inclusions, there are environmental performances, and there are economic development, and with each sector, we can join biological sector. In the economic development, we know vaccines, enzymes, hormones, all pharmaceutical products, so many cosmetics, all these things. In the environment, we can say that how pollution can be mitigated with the help of biological agency. These are the things which will make us Atmanirbhar Panu in more and more manner once we are aware about the particular aspects of the biological sciences. So we can say that the role of our faculty and the role of every person, right, when we can say that environmental education is a steering person here, is a steering topic here, that with the help of environmental education, we can have more coordinated manner at all levels of implementation to find out the better solution against all the challenges, all the odds, all the hurdles. And with the help of cooperation, the spirit of cooperation, the spirit of teamwork, as in our Gujarati we say that jaja hath radyamna che, and in our Gujarati another saying is very nice: to become Atmanirbhar, we have to remember this saying also, that tipe tipe sarovar bharai, kankre kane paad bande. Our good old people were used to tell us that a small stone also, a small pebble also is playing very important role, because so many pebbles will come together and then they will construct a wall. So when I say that Atma, we say that it is myself. Now how do I look at myself? Myself as an individual, myself as a teacher, myself as a faculty, myself as a unit of society, myself as a citizenship, citizen of this nation, myself as a part, smallest part in the scientific community, myself as a role in the independent growth of our nation. And if we can merge this myself with our country, then we can say that our teamwork will be capable to make us in the most potential, most effective, most disciplined working capability, which will make us towards more and more Atmanirbhar in our country. How many times we are thinking that what is my role in the reduction of pollution? How much pollution is generated due to all the vehicles on the roads? How many things a person can do, then a person can spread in the society, and if every one of us can contribute, then we can say that that is our role to become Atmanirbhar. Thank you, dear friends. Let us hope that all our contributions get reflected in the prosperity of the whole universe. Okay. So, as a whole, in the conclusion, you know what I wanted to say, that how biological science will make us maximum capable, and what is the role of a faculty to produce and to cultivate such kind of the culture that it will implement, it will affect our self-reliance of our country. So we must remember that what is our role in the maintenance of Mother Earth, how to make Mother Earth free from the pollution, how to make our country more self-reliant with the help of novel technologies, with the help of biological agencies. Not only plant, animal and microbes, but biological agency means we as a human being, each and every person, what we can contribute to become more self-sufficient, self-reliant, and not to depend on other countries, not to depend on any other, but how to become self-dependent. Svavalambana. Svanu avalamban. Kevi rite kari shakye. Biological science ni madad thi. Ketli badhi housewife svanu avalamban kari shakye che jyare kitchen waste bhegu karine emathi fertilizer kare. કેટલા બધા ટર્નકી પ્રોજેક્ટ્સ મહારાષ્ટ્ર તમિલનાડુમાં ચાલે છે, જ્યાં બધા બિલ્ડિંગ્સને ઇલેક્ટ્રિસિટી બાયોલોજિકલ મટીરિયલ પૂરું પડે છે. સો ધીઝ આર ધ સ્મોલર એન્ડ સ્મોલ સ્મોલ સ્ટેપ્સ વિલ લીડ અસ ટુવર્ડ્સ બિગર સ્ટેપ ટુ બીકમ સેલ્ફ સફિશિયન્ટ. થેન્ક યુ ડિયર ફ્રેન્ડ્સ, હોપ વી કુડ હેવ ઇન્સ્પિરેશન મોર એન્ડ મોર ફ્રોમ અવર રિસ્પેક્ટેડ સાયન્ટિફિક કોમ્યુનિટીઝ from the field, not only from biological science, but from all the sectors. Thank you to KCG to give me this particular platform to share my views, to share my inner feelings about what I understand with the help of the word Atmanirbhar. Thank you. Thank you to the team KCG. Thank you to Higher Education, Government of Gujarat. Thank you so much.
It's a pleasure, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you for giving your valuable time and being present at KCG, ma'am. It was actually a pleasure having you at this session. I once again thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your valuable time.